Hi, you're on Public Spot. I'm George. Today, I will show you how I set up a website using AWS Cloudfront and S3 Bucket. So, let's start coding. So first things first, what do we need as prerequisites to what we're doing today? First, we need a registered domain. And for this video, I registered mine using Freenome, which is a website that provides free domains for a short period of time. But if you're serious about setting up a website for yourself and you want to leverage on what I will be showing you in this video, it's probably worth registering an official domain for yourself. The second one is an AWS account. Because we will be creating AWS resources, you need to have an AWS account. And if you're watching this video and following through the steps, please note that creating the resources could cost you some money. And I suggest destroying the infrastructure at the end once we're done, so you don't have to incur so much cost. And then lastly, we need our code and our artifacts related to our static website. And in this video, I'm not going to show you how to develop a website. I will quickly show you how I generate my website artifacts, but that's about it. Now that that's out of the way, let's start writing some code. I'll start with the S3 bucket that we hold my website artifacts. So I will set up the bare minimum properties for this S3 bucket and then update the properties as we go along. So as usual, we'll start with our main.tf and then write our Terraform code from here. So now that our bare minimum properties are defined, we've got some undefined properties in here. I've got a variable and a local that tags that I need to set up. So let's do that. To lock down and restrict direct public access to my S3 bucket for security reasons, I will create another resource called S3 bucket public access block and turn all the flags to true. Now, let's create our CloudFront distribution resource. Like what I did with my S3 bucket, I will set the very bare minimum properties for this resource, and then you can make modifications as you see fit. I'll write up the Terraform code, and then we can go back to it later on and talk about some of the parts that we need to fill in. Let's populate the properties that I've set with question marks and start from the top. So first is aliases. So we probably need to define this as a variable, but this is going to be the endpoint that we will expose to the internet. And because we are pulling that from a variable, we need to define a corresponding entry in our variables.tf. And then domain name needs to point to the bucket original domain name of our website S3 bucket. And then we can set the origin ID as the same as the domain name. With the origin access identity, we will need to create a new resource that identifies our CloudFront resource and also allows connection between our CloudFront and our S3 bucket. So let's scroll down and create our origin access identity resource. And then we put a comment property on that resource to identify the OAI specific to our endpoint. We then go back to our CloudFront property and update the value. Let's toggle the explorer so we can see the whole content of our main.tf. So I've set origin access identity to point to our origin access identity resource, particularly the property CloudFront access identity path. So what I need to do next is to set up a way for my CloudFront resource to be able to talk to my S3 bucket using this origin access identity. So this can be achieved by creating a new resource called AWS S3 bucket policy. So let's do that. In here, I will set my bucket to point to the S3 bucket, and then I'll set a policy that would set the permission for my CloudFront access to the S3 bucket. This policy will be pointing to a data reference that will define the permissions of my CloudFront to the S3 bucket. So let's create a data reference for that policy. So what I've defined in this policy document is an S3 get object permission to the S3 bucket that we've defined along with all the resources inside that bucket and granting permission to the origin access identity resource that we defined earlier. So now that we have that defined, let's go back to our resource and update the policy reference. So now let's go back to our CloudFront distribution resource and review what else we need to fill in. Target origin identity, which is pretty much the origin identity that we've defined in this block. Because we've just used the same bucket regional name, we just use that same value in there. And let's have a look at what's next. So this property here needs to point to a certificate resource. So this is to ensure that I am using TLS on my website, which means my website will be accessed using HTTPS, which generally indicates that the website is secure. So let's go ahead and create that certificate resource. Note that as per AWS requirement, we need to create this certificate resource in US East 1 so that CloudFront can read the certificate. So we need to add a provider alias for the region, and let's go ahead and set that up. So what I've created here is two sets of provider blocks. One is defaulting to the region that we want the other resources to be created in. And then we created another provider here that defaults to US East 1 and set an alias US East 1. This provider is going to be referenced by the creation of the certificate resource. So now that we've set this provider alias, let's go back to our main.tf on that certificate resource and populate the properties. This certificate needs to be validated so that AWS can verify that I legitimately own the domain that I'm setting the certificate with. So I need to set up Route 53 validation resources. So first, I need to create Cname resources for my certificates. So I need to create Route 53 record resources for it. The property that is missing on our certificate validation is the zone ID right here. This needs to point to a Route 53 hosted zone. So let's go ahead and create the data reference to this resource. So now that we have that data reference set up, let's go ahead and update our certificate resource with this reference. Now that we have our certificate fully set up, let's go ahead and update our CloudFront resource to reference this certificate. We also need to update our CloudFront distribution to set up a default root object property and point that to index.html. With our CloudFront resource done, I need to create a resource that allows a URL to talk to this CloudFront resource. So we need to create a Route 53 record. Let's go ahead and fill up the missing items on our Route 53 resource. Zone ID needs to point to the hosted zone ID reference for our domain. And then the name and the zone ID needs to point to the properties of our CloudFront distribution. We also need to set up our missing variables. So if you remember, I set up a provider's block in here that accepts region as a variable. So I need to define a region variable inside my variables.tf. In our certificate resource, we are also referencing another variable in here called domain underscore name. So we need to define that as well. So at this point, I have pretty much written the meat of my Terraform code. And what I will do next is to transform this block into a module that I could reuse. So this means I will not be running my Terraform commands inside this directory, but I will create another directory that will reference all the Terraform configuration files that I've identified in here. I will create a new set of Terraform code and start using the module block. So what I've done in here is I've created a module, call it my website, and it's actually referencing that directory. And then I pass the parameters endpoint, domain name, region, and bucket name based on what's defined on the variables.tf inside this directory. I also need to define backend.tf that will hold my Terraform state files. So what I've done here is I've reused the same configuration that I've set up on having an S3 bucket as a Terraform backend. Created an episode on setting up S3 bucket as Terraform backend. So if you want to know more, I will add a link on this video in the description below. I also need to set up a provider.tf and variables.tf. Then let's start writing our makefile that would chain up all our Terraform commands. And then this way we can be more efficient with our Terraform runs. So at this point, I'm ready to start running my Terraform commands. Let's open terminal, cd to that directory where we need to run our commands. So it'll be my website. And then we can start exporting some variables that we need for the run and then run our first init. So this is kind of expected. So what we need to do is we need to cancel this prompt and then we need to create our workspace on our Terraform backend. So with our new workspace created, let's start running our init again. And then let's start running our plan. I just realized something that needs to be fixed on our makefile. So let's fix that. So let's run our Terraform plan again. So just to quickly touch what the issue is, earlier I didn't have any parentheses in there. The makefile doesn't like that. And if you notice, it has actually created this strange file in here, which we don't need. So let's just get rid of that. The plan has run successfully. So let's go ahead and apply this. So it looks like the apply failed. And let's have a look. There are two errors on the apply, one of which is an invalid value for forwarded headers. So let's go ahead and fix that. We need to go to our CloudFront distribution resource, which is this one, and then look for the forwarded values property, which is this one, line 44. Apparently, S3 static website does not accept star. So all we need to do is get rid of that star and send an empty header set. Save that. So this resource not found exception that we see for our certificate validation is because the validation resource is trying to validate the certificate on a different region instead of US is one where the certificate actually lives. So to fix this, we just need to add our provider alias the same way as what we did with our certificate. So scroll up to our certificate, copy this, and put it inside the certificate validation resource. Save all our changes, and then let's run our apply again. So Terraform apply completed successfully, which means our S3 website infrastructure has been stood up. So let's go ahead and try accessing our website. So let's open a browser and then go to mywebsite.hubspot.ml. So we're getting this error because our S3 bucket is empty. So we don't have any static files pushed into that bucket yet. Now, let me show you the static website code or artifacts that I will use for this exercise. So let's quickly switch our VS Code. So just to quickly touch on some points about this website, this has been developed using Angular, and I have the website artifacts produced under the dist directory. So the contents of the dist directory is what I'm going to end up pushing to the S3 bucket. So let's do that. Let's open terminal. Export our AWS profile. And then inside the dist directory, I'm going to run AWS sync to my S3 bucket. And now let's open our browser again and refresh that page. And there you go. The page is actually loading fine. And this is the website that I've set up. So that's a wrap. As usual, please let me know what you think on the comments below. Send me some likes or share this video if you find it useful, and subscribe to this channel. Until next time, see ya.